Okay. Coach, like, we talked about them being long a little bit before the game, right?
Being what?
Being long.
Oh, long.
Long. Yeah. And that seemed to bother you. The points in the paint kind of got away from you. What happened? What was the reason that there weren't a lot of adjustments made to kind of eliminate that?
Well, I didn't think their length bothered us so much other than on the glass. And we did make a lot of adjustments. We actually did every pick and roll coverage we have, plus zone. We just got flat out out-competed. It doesn't matter if you were long or short or whatever. We just got out-competed. They played harder, which is, you know, disappointing given everything that we have to play for.
Gafford, I mean, getting a lot of dunks, like just like the first game, it seemed like. Was that disappointing just after they were able to do that to you in the first one to have the same thing happen this time around? Or?
Yeah, I mean, we just we didn't play with any presence, any physicality at the rim. So.
Did you get a sense that did they expect Washington to just kind of lay down or anything like that? It just didn't seem the force was there.
Hey, those questions you can ask them when they come in here. You know, we knew that this team wasn't a tank team. They were coming in to play hard. They were trying to figure out who they were, get some momentum going into the season, playing hard. They won four of their last six. We didn't have the extra gear and the extra determination that we needed when everything that we have to play for, and we didn't. So.
Seeing Jaden get it back out there, any just initial thoughts of how that looked?
I mean, it looked like he moved pretty far, pretty well. He didn't really get into the rhythm of the game, but we kind of expected that.
Seems like this group sometimes has a propensity to just try to outscore teams below them in the standings. Do you think just kind of got bit by that tonight because you're not going to shoot the lights out, I guess, every game?
Yeah, that might be true. You know, I don't know. We didn't really guard them. You know, and it was evident from the very beginning. And when you get into one of those games, all you got to do is hit one cold streak, which we did at the beginning of the fourth quarter, and it's over. So,
what have you seen defensively from this team in the last 3 weeks or so here?
It's just the inability to contain the ball right now is really hurting us. You know, we can't really sit down and guard the ball. So.
When you start off a game struggling on the defensive end, how hard can it be to turn it on in terms of guarding or ball containment if it kind of starts that way?
It's always hard to turn it on when you're not 100% focused, you know, especially when you're a younger team. We tried to get a little bit more aggressive. We tried to, you know, when we were able to get stops, we couldn't get rebounds, and those were also really deflating at times. So,
anything that you learned from tonight and the compete level and what it's going to take going forward here?
The games that we have coming up next week, you know, obviously between now and next week even. We just got to play way better. You know, we are not ready to compete at that level. We're not going to get a lot done. So.
Chris, do you think that there are trends that have gone on defensively? You said about guarding the ball, but just in terms of the shape that this defense is in going into really important games.
Yeah, we're just not physical enough, John. We're not putting our body on anybody. We're not making it hard for the ball handler. We're not making it hard for people coming off actions right now. We're too loose. We're too soft there. We just, as a result, seem a bit like a step late to the play.
Can you defend in the playoffs if not all five guys are committed on that end?
Probably not.